Hey friends, and welcome to another hair tutorial slash hair review here on my channel, Putting Up With The Pompons. My name is Shantae, and in this video, I received this Afro puff with a bang off of Amazon, and I'm gonna let y'all know the tea on this style. So we're gonna talk longevity, we're gonna also talk versatility, and my first opinion out the box. So of course, before we go any further, if you are new to my channel, do not forget to hit that subscribe button located right below this video. Come join the family. We would love to have you. And to all of my returning subscribers, hey bestie, hey mama, hey friend, hope you are being blessed and safe as always. All right, so now that we got all the formalities out the way, let's get into it. So here is the unit off from Amazon, and this is what it looks like in the picture. So this is what I'm expecting. So opening it up, first thing out the box, I won't say that I was like super impressed, or I was just like, oh my gosh. To be honest, I thought this was gonna be a boring piece. I'm not gonna lie to you. I really thought it was gonna be boring. I thought it was just gonna be a typical puff. No big deal about it. But here it is. So it has a drawstring for you to adjust it to your liking. And then the front with the bang is, there is a clip there for you to attach it to your ponytail, of course, once you have your hairstyle. So let's talk natural hair real quick. So my hair is styled in some twists, and these are some throw-in twists. These are not the kind of twists that I do if I'm doing a twist out, even though I could probably still do a twist out. This isn't my usual twist out like method, or you know, my remedy. So what I'm doing here is taking out my twist, and what I did was I washed my hair a couple of days ago, and when I don't know what to do with my natural hair, this is my go-to style. These dookie plaits right here is my go-to style. I use the As I Am Twist Defining Cream. That was the product you saw me holding up in the beginning where I was doing my little showgirl. But that was it. That's the only thing I use. Now I am very heavy-handed with that Twist Defining Cream, and as you can see, those curls look good after I took it out. So if I was willing to do a twist out, it probably could have worked, but it was a little more frizzier than I would like. That's why I say that's not my typical twist out. Now I will do an updated video for you guys on how I do my twist outs and what products I use and the methods that I go about creating my twist out, but for the sake of this video, we just taking out those twists, brushing them out, and then I put them back into twists just to kind of keep them out of my way, because I want to start with the back section first of my head, and then we're gonna work with the front. So I'm pulling all that hair up into that high ponytail, and as you can see, I did not take all the twists out. I left some of them in, and that's my guide to where I want my bun slash ponytail to be. I went in with a little bit of water just to kind of help slick it down. Of course, natural hair works best when it comes to slicking down with when it is wet. And then I'm gonna go in with some gel. Of course, y'all know I love my Shine Effects conditioning gel, so I'm lathering that all up, and I make sure I get all them BDBs, because we do not want our kitchen to look toe up back there. We're about to put our hair into a high puff, and y'all know I brush the back of that neck, okay? Brush that neck. So we're pulling that all up into a ponytail, and then I'm going to section it off and make small twists out of that ponytail. This just kind of helps me with making a small and uniform bun. I'm not trying to go for the messy bun with this hairstyle, because I'm putting something over the bun, and I don't want the messy bun to cause more problems. So I twist it up and then kind of secure it with bobby pins and rubber bands. Whatever is your preferred method is all up to you. Then once we secure the back, we're gonna go ahead and jump to the front. Breaking my hair down into these sections to do this slick ponytail or bun definitely helps out, okay? Because my shoulders, arms, all that be burning when I'm trying to style my hair into any kind of updo or trying to put it into any kind of ponytail. Honey, this is a arm workout day. So I'm doing the same process that I did it to the back of the hair. I'm doing the same thing to the front. Of course, I pay a lot more attention to the front, because the front is what you're gonna see, and that's what I see. So I'm gonna make sure that front look good. So I'm slicking that on down with my gel, taking my brush to smooth it on out, and then I'm taking a ponytail holder. Now this time I'm gonna do a little bit different method to securing the bun. My hair is a lot thicker nowadays, so this is how I go about securing my hair with a ponytail holder versus the traditional way. And as you can see, I just kind of wrap it around, loop it through, and then I'm gonna tuck it underneath the ponytail holder, pretty much. That's it, and that's what secures it. It don't budge. I have never had a problem where the thing decided to just pop itself loose or none of that. So of course, all that loose hair right there, we're gonna twist those up and create a small bun and secure that with a rubber band. And let's move on to this puff bangs. I spent most of my time styling my hair alone, so I'm praying that this unit ain't gonna give me that much of a hassle. So here she is in all her glory. So like I said, she has a drawstring. There's a comb in the back to secure it to your bun. And then there's a clip where the bang is to secure that to your ponytail. So here I am. I'm just adjusting the strap back there and I'm just putting it to my tightness. Of course, not too tight because we don't want to cause no stress on the hair. And then I'm taking that clip, and that was an easy like snap clip. And I didn't really have to worry about that budging or anything. So that string that was hanging out, I just tucked that right back up into the puff. No big deal. I didn't bobby pin anything. And now there is a couple of curls that are kind of hanging a little too low for me. So of course I got my scissors and I snipped those right on out. I did a couple of little fluffing and adjusting because of course she just came out the bag. So she did need a little bit of adjustment. But no extra product, water, or anything was added to this unit. Alright y'all, so that completes the review for this bun with a bang. I will say that I was shockingly surprised about how much I enjoyed creating this look. I feel like with this, it gives me a little bit less of a hassle. Like, this is really a throw on and go type of unit. I fluffed it. I didn't add any product, no water, nothing. I trimmed maybe a few pieces. Like, I literally have like maybe 10 to 12 curls on my floor for where I just like did small snips in certain areas just so it could fit my face, and where curls weren't able to tuck in, I would clip those. And then y'all know I love versatility, so I have to see if a wig is versatile, and I will say it checked off on the versatility. I can pair out my different head wraps, different headbands, or I can wear it by itself, simply by itself, and it will still look good. You can add in some bobby pins or some, you know, decorative hair pins or clips to the side or to pin into the afro to kind of make it look cute. I even thought about taking some sunflower clips and like decorating it with that. I'm like, yes, this could be the same wig, but you can always change up accessorizing it. And I love that about this. And you know, that kind of like, I love a wig that kind of like piques my interest when it comes to what are different ways that I can style it. As far as longevity, I did wear this throughout the entire day, and I am going to wear it to work probably this week because my hair is up in a bun at this point. There was no multiple checking in the mirror to make sure like it was still set on my head the right way. Like, I had no issues with that. It was a little windy today, so I think my only concern about the wind was probably like it blowing the bang, and you could probably see like the piece that holds the bang together. Anyways, but I did enjoy styling this unit. Like, I really feel like it is quick and easy. It came in other colors as well. The link is provided down below if you want to check out this unit for yourself. You can purchase it on Amazon, and I will say that I really thoroughly enjoyed it, and I really thought this was going to be a boring piece. Thank you guys for joining us on another hair tutorial slash review here on my channel, Putting Up With The Pom Poms. I will see y'all on another one. Be blessed and be safe.